I'm Jeff McDowell, and I'm going to be talking about access governance in SharePoint, OneDrive, and Teams. In this session, you're going to learn about challenges governing access to your data in the cloud and how SharePoint, OneDrive, and Teams can help with those challenges by providing you some tools and capabilities that you can use. First, we're going to talk about the content governance landscape and how it looks like today. Governance controls available in Microsoft 365 to help address your unique challenges. And then we're going to sum things up and give you some links that you can follow up and take a look at for more information. So organizations storing their data in the cloud face a unique challenge. The exponential growth of digital data can make it difficult to govern and manage easily. Insights and tools are really needed to help keep track of how your data is being accessed and from where and from what devices and where your data lives once it's in the cloud. To help you manage that, we're going to take a look at some of the governance controls that are available in SharePoint, OneDrive, and Teams to address these challenges. For starters, a great way to get started with access governance and information governance is using Microsoft Information Protection Labels. To simplify governance of your content, you can classify your data using Microsoft Information Protection Labels. And these are labels that help you manage the sensitivity of your content. It'll let you know what content is confidential, highly confidential, top secret, or belongs to a certain department within your organization, such as legal or finance. And you can apply these Microsoft Information Protection Labels at various different granularities. So either at the Teams or the SharePoint site level, or even at the per document level. And you can have these labels applied by your users directly as they're creating the content, or by your administrators, or even automatically based on rules relating to the contents of your documents. For more information on Microsoft Information Protection Labels, a great session to check out would be the Introduction to Microsoft Information Protection Labels, where they'll go into that in a little bit more detail. So once you have your data classified using sensitivity labels, you can keep track of it using the Content Explorer. This is a tool in the Microsoft 365 Compliance Admin Center that lets you do a deep dive on where your data is located based on the sensitivity label. So if you have top secret data, you can take a look at where that lives across OneDrive or SharePoint, for example, and deep dive into each of those locations in order to figure out what type of sensitive content is being put there and to learn more information about it. You can also use the Office 365 audit log to help keep track of your sensitive content and create alerts based on certain types of activities. For example, you could identify or alert when a sensitive document is added to a less sensitive or unprotected location. So to give an example of how that works, I'm going to do a quick demo here for the Content Explorer and audit log search. So here we are in the Microsoft 365 Admin Center for Woodgrove Bank. And you can see that we've created a couple labels already for our organization. So we have a general label, confidential, top secret, and a couple labels that are specific to certain departments within the company. If we take a look at the top secret label, you can see that we've attached some policy to this label in order to protect these highly sensitive documents. So we've applied encryption so that only certain people can access top secret documents. And we've also made it so that sites or teams that are labeled top secret can block access from devices not managed by my organization. So I've already got some great access governance just built in with the Microsoft Information Protection label. If I want to find out more information about how my top secret documents are being used, I can switch over to the Compliance Admin Center and look at the Content Explorer under the Data Classification tab. And that's going to give me, if I look at Top Secret and I drill down into SharePoint, for example, that's going to give me a view of all the different SharePoint sites where Top Secret documents are being stored. As an admin, I can review this and take some action. For example, if I know that the brokerage team is a site where I'm doing a bunch of collaboration with external partners or external users, and I know that Top Secret documents maybe shouldn't live there, I can drill in and see what are the Top Secret documents that are living on this site, and take a look at those documents directly to see if they've been labeled appropriately or find out more information on, you know, when they got there and who created them to take further action. I can also go over to the audit log and I can look for a history of when these top secret documents have been added to my various sites. I can search for activities for just that specific site collection, for example, or I can look across my entire organization when documents have been labeled sensitive. when the sensitivity labels have been applied to documents or sites. I can search based on this, or I can set up alerts based on certain types of activities. For example, if I want to look at a document sensitivity mismatch, which is when a sensitive file is added to a less sensitive site, for example, I can set up a search based on that. And I can see the results of when that's been happening in my organization during the time range that I specify. I can also set up alerts. So in this case, you can see that this international marketing strategies document was added to our brokerage team's site. And that's a sensitive document being added to a less sensitive site. So a result appears. I can also set up alerts directly from the audit log. If I want one of my administrators to get notification the next time this occurs, I can create an alert policy. So those are some ways that you can view where your sensitive information is stored and track the activities that have been happening. Let's talk a little bit more about guests outside of your company accessing information. So as we mentioned before, on our brokerage site, we know that we have guests from outside of the organization accessing content in that site. And this is fairly common. You could have contracts that you need to send to your customers. You could have business partnerships where you want to collaborate closely with some other organization. So you have certain pieces of content within your organization where you do want to share them with users outside of the company. For this, we give you a set of controls in the SharePoint Online Admin Center to manage external sharing either across your enterprise or on a site-by-site basis. You can also control how long guests can have access. So you can set things up so that when a guest is invited to collaborate with you on a document, they can have access for 30 days or 60 days. But then after that period of time, the site owner has to go reaffirm that they still have a business need to access the content. You can also have your site owners review permissions of who has access to what using external sharing reports. So let's take a look at that in a little bit more detail right now. So here we are in the SharePoint Admin Center for Woodgrove Bank, and we're on the sharing policy page. And here we give you controls to manage how guests from outside of your organization can access your content. So to begin with, you can control guest access all up across your entire organization for both SharePoint and OneDrive. Yeah, you can determine if you want only certain guests to be able to access, or if you want to allow your users to invite new guests, or if you want to block guest access entirely. You can also control this on a site-by-site basis if you want to have a bit more granular control. And finally, you can specify how long guests will have access. So if we want to make it so that a guest will expire after 60 days, that's how we've got that set up currently. And we can take a look at what that means if we go over to our brokerage site that we were talking about earlier. So here we have the brokerage site, and in this site, we're collaborating with some external guests. And I can also see that we have this top secret document that we identified a few minutes ago, International Marketing Strategies document. And so as the site owner, I want to see, you know, what's being shared and with who, and whether or not this top secret document has been shared outside of my organization. So the first thing I can do is I can go to the site permissions, and this lets me manage guest access. So if I have guests in the site and any of them are about to lose their access, I can manage and refresh their access here if they still have a business need to access the content. The next thing I can do is I can do a deep dive into which document has been shared and with whom. And to do that, I can run something called a site sharing report. So if I go to the site usage page and I come down to the bottom, I can run a sharing report that's going to tell me for each of these documents what's been shared by whom. So this gives me the ability to run this report here. And I've gone ahead and run it already, and it's going to produce a report that looks like this. And this is going to tell me in detail for each of the documents in my site who it's been shared with and what type of sharing has occurred. So I can see, for example, that a couple of the documents have sharing links created within my organization. I can also see that this Canada product overview presentation and central partnership guidance presentation have been shared with users outside of my organization. I can see this external user, Jeff McDowell, has access to these documents. But I can also see that my top secret document has not been shared with anyone. So that's good for me to know. And based on this information, I can take some action. I can either move the top secret document to a more appropriate location, or I can reclassify it, or I can change the policies on this site accordingly. So let's sum up what we've talked about today. To simplify governance, a great first step is to classify your data using Microsoft Information Protection labels. Once you do that, you can keep track of your sensitive data using the Content Explorer and monitor activities and set up alerts with the audit log. You can also control how data is being shared outside of your organization to guests or business partners using the tools available to you in the SharePoint Online Admin Center. If you want to learn more about any of these topics or any of the other tools we have available across SharePoint Online, OneDrive, and Teams for security and compliance, take a look at the Microsoft 365 Governance Corner for more information. And thank you very much for listening today.